While it's not perfect, overall, I'm very much enjoying the adult world of Harry Potter. But that's because I believe it's going to get more adult as we work our way through 5 frickin' movies. But even though they have 5 films to tell this story, I hope they pick the pace up a bit more. I hope they give us more to work with. And this is an interesting situation because the Harry Potter movies were based off of books, obviously. And while this, of course, is ripped from the lore of Potter that J.K. Rowling has established, it's never been told specifically. You know, this legend and through Newt's eyes, etc., is being told for the first time in the movies. So for all of you who are like, oh, it's canon that Dumbledore and Grindelwald don't meet until their big battle again. But they met in the past. They have a history. It's called a flashback, thank you very much. But, you know, I think the it's in the books, it's canon argument isn't quite as strong with these movies. Because it's like, you're telling the story for the first time. You can do whatever you damn want. And don't be backpedaling on this Dumbledore-Grindelwald romance, J.K. Rowling. I think that's really going to bite her in the butt if they end up doing that. But let's take a look. I love the first trailer, and I'm very excited to see what they brought to Comic-Con. All right, here we go. This was from the first trailer.
I'm scared, Professor Dumbledore.
Everyone is scared of something.
It's like, why do these kids always bring their problems to me?
Newt, you're up next. That's an unusual one. What Mr. Scamander fears above everything else is...
having to work in an office, sir.
Go ahead, Newt.
It's kind of insulting. I thought he was going to say deadlines. That would be more endearing.
Magic blooms only in rare souls. Still, we must skulk in shadows.
So beautiful. Wow, that was cool.
But the old ways serve us no longer.
They've awoken Johnny Depp.
I take it.
You've heard the rumors. Grindelwald had a vision that he would rise to dominance over the wizarding world.
So you're asking me to help hunt him down?
I can't move against Grindelwald. It has to be you. In your shoes, I'd probably refuse to. It's late. Good evening, Newt.
Oh, come on.
You underestimate your talents, Mr. Scamander.
This isn't up to the beasts anymore.
Their arrogance is a key to our victory.
Unless the humans are the crazies before them, you know. The magical people are the beasts, the real
Muggles
beasts.
Muggles are not lesser. Disposable.
You're too good, Newt. You never met a monster you couldn't love.
That's a great line.
Treat
That's
it.
A very good line. That's an amazing line. We should have started the trailer with that line.
Mr. Scamander!
Do you think Dumbledore will mourn for you?
Johnny Depp's like, I haven't played a wizard my whole life. Might as well make it official.
Are you a ghost?
No. I'm alive. But I'm an alchemist and therefore immortal.
Oh.
Nicolas Flamel.
Jacob Quals.
Oh.
Oh. You don't look a day over 375.
That looks very, very, very good. It's still, I feel, a little overly complicated, just like I felt with the first movie. I mean, I don't know why Newt Scamander and these, you know, it's just another group of students, right? But I guess J.K. Rowling's like, hey, I have a formula. Leave me alone. And it seems to be working, so I'm not going to say anything. Too much. But, you know, I think we all want Dumbledore versus Grindelwald. That's what's really interesting. And I think it looks like two fabulous performances. And I did see that Jude Law gave an interview, and he said that Dumbledore is drawn to Newt because Newt likes animals and, you know, things, you know, beasts and, you know, Dumbledore dealing with his sexuality and other things, you know, feels out of place and like he's a misfit. And so that's why he's drawn to Newt. So I think that works, you know, that makes Newt why he would be stuck between these people. And everyone else is like, don't talk to those guys. You know, they're going to cause a lot of problems. And Newt can't help himself, right? Because he always gives animals and people the benefit of the doubt. But they need to play that up more. I mean, a lot of times an author will say, oh, it's in there if you look for it, right? But I think it's an author's responsibility to make sure that the themes are very clear, very strong, and run throughout the piece. That's really good writing. I'm sure someone's like, how dare you talk about J.K. Rowling as if it's up for discussion. You know, she's cutting her teeth as a screenwriter here. Is she the screenwriter? She wrote the first one. Yep. And screenwriting, jumping from medium to medium, is a very different business. So how'd it look to you? Write your thoughts down below. Thank you for watching with me. And you can check out some more videos right now.